Yep.
If we go back to our previous example, to go from acetate to acetic acid, you add a hydrogen ion. So that's the difference.
Yep.
That's, frankly, what a buffer is. And I don't know if you realize this, but this example with the common ion we did just a bit ago.
We made a buffer solution.
We made a buffer solution right here. Yeah. See, because we had 0.1 of each. This is actually called sort of an ideal buffer because you have exactly the same molarities of both. And so you have made an ideal buffer where they have, and you have both the acetic acid and his partner, or the weak base, conjugate base, acetate, and they are the same quantity. Yeah. It just has to be within the factor of 10.
Has anyone ever told you you're ideally buff?
I am ideally buff. My wife has said I'm the ideal husband.
It doesn't count.
She's amazing. She knows everything.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, that's true. Okay, all right. So now let's do an example here. Again, this is an acetic acid sodium acetate solution. Now we've got some volumes going on here, so let's see if we can figure out. What is the pH of a solution where 50 milliliters of 0.5 molar acetic acid, sodium acetate, is mixed with 25 milliliters of 0.25 molar acetic acid? All right, this is a little confusing. So what we need to do is actually, let me say one more thing about buffers. What units can you work with? Typically, you need to work with molarity units. And later on, we'll learn that you can actually, if it's buffered, if, only if buffered, you can actually also work with moles or even millimoles. And we'll do that as the unit progresses. All right, let's go back to this problem. Now, first of all, we've got sodium acetate and acetic acid.
Do not add them together.
I don't do this?
No.
Why not?
Because you don't put them on the same side. They're partners. Partners go on opposite sides.
This is wrong. You must not do wrong thing. Okay, so you actually break it down. HC2H3O. You just write the regular equation, the dissociation of the weak acid or the weak base. So this makes hydrogens and acetates. Now, we do have an issue is that we want to work with molarity units. Okay, so let's think this through.
Yeah.
Okay, I have 50 milliliters of 0.5 molar sodium acetate. So I have 50 milliliters of 0.5 molar.
Mm-hmm.
So 50 times 0.5 is 25
millimoles.
Now, the way we got that, that's MV equals moles. And I'm leaving it in millimoles, so I do not convert this to liters. So I have 25 millimoles, and that's of the acetate. Now, the other question, that's not brackets. And what was the other chemical I had?
Acetic acid, and you have 25 milliliters.
25 of 0.25. So I have 25 milliliters of 0.25 molar, and this is the acetic acid. And is that 12?
That's 6.25.
6.25 millimoles of the acetic acid. Now, since we want to work in molarities, I have a total volume when I pour these together of 50 plus 25 or 75 milliliters. So the molarity of this would be 0.33 molar for the acetate, and this would be 6 1/4 divided by 75.
0.08333333333.
And that's, molar. I didn't do that right. I didn't show that right, but you get the idea. So now I can go back to my equilibrium problem. And then the initial concentration of the acetate, did I do this right, Mr. James?
0.33.
And this was 0.083.
Yep.
And this is my ice table. Minus X, 0.083 minus X. Now, I know this is buffered, by the way. How do I know it's buffered?
Because we have the acid and its partner.
So if you look here, highlighted in green, I have the partner and I have the acid, and they are within a factor of 10 of each other, aren't they? So now I simply just plug it into my cool KI equation. We're working with acetic acid, so our Ka is still 1.8.
Mr. Bergmann, your E for acetate is incorrect.
Oh, it's, yes, X. So 0.33 plus X.
There you go.
I was testing it.
I knew, I figured.
So X times 0.33 plus X. Now this one, those terms won't cancel, of course, because they are not the same number, are they?
Nope.
So now we plug it into our solver. So Mr. Sams is being the solver king right now, and he's going to solve for X. So make sure you know how to do that. That's important. We're not going to go for that right now, though. So X, and X is the concentration of the hydrogen, if you look at the equation, right? I'll go back here. X right here. I want to change that to pink. X and the hydrogen, right? And so X, when you do the solver thing,
is
equal to
4.5 times 10 to the negative 6.
So to find the pH, which the question asked for, the pH is the
negative log
of the hydrogen concentration, or this number right here, 4.5, and that comes out
5.34.
So the answer is 5.34.
Now, does that make sense?
Well, let's ask that
question.
Let's think.
Okay, we've got some acetic acid, and we have some acetate.
Okay.
So it's going to be an acidic buffer solution because we're dealing with a weak acid, and that's an acidic pH, so that makes sense.
Yeah. Now, one thing to note here, yeah, that's fine. I would say because the Ka of this is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, so it's a stronger acid than this is a base.
Right.
This would be about 10 to the minus 9. 9 and 5 is 14.
Yep.
And so this is a weaker base than this is an acid. Because if it was reverse the case, it would actually be the other way around.
Right.
All right. And I think we have one more thing to do here. The Henderson-Hasselbach equation? Yeah, we're almost done. All right. Now, there's a cool equation. I love this equation.
As do I.
The Henderson-Hasselbach equation.
I called it the David Hasselhoff equation.
David Hasselhoff?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Hasselhoff. Just because Hasselhoff sounds like Hasselbach and it's fun to say.
Oh.
So then
there's a famous football player whose name is Hasselbach.
Oh. We always called it then the Baywatch equation when I was in college.
The Baywatch
equation?
Because
David Hasselhoff was in this horrible TV show called Baywatch.
Baywatch. Oh, that's with the bimbos on the beach.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
I never watched that show.
Yeah, I don't blame you. It's pretty dumb.
Okay. Okay.
But anyhow, that's what we
So here it is. pH equals pKa. We're going to have to talk about what that means in a minute. E plus the log of the base over the acid. What does a sheep say?
Bah.
Base over acid. So that's easy to remember. Okay. Now, what's a pKa?
Well, if pH is the negative log of hydrogens, then pKa is probably going to be the negative log of our Ka.
That's correct. So now, the beauty of this particular situation is that we do not have to do all this equilibrium problem we just did.
This is called a shortcut, folks.
We like shortcuts. So what we had to do is this whole big equilibrium problem right here. And I think, did I then solve? No.
For pH?
Yeah. If I want to remember,
we solved for pH.
But we did, but we solved it the long way.
Yes.
Right? So, so what I want to do now is I'll actually, you know, this last problem, we got 5.34 when we just solved this. And so, guys, what I want to do is under this space under the Henderson-Hasselbach, I'm going to resolve this equation, use the Henderson-Hasselbach equation. Now, the first thing I need to do is I need to find the pKa. So the pKa is going to be the negative log of the Ka. Now, the Ka in this case, if you recall, is 1.8. times 10 to the minus 5. So I just take the negative log of that, and I get what?
4.74.
So Mr. Sams on his calculator has just typed that in. So the equation is pH equals pKa plus the log of the base, the concentration of the base, over the concentration of the acid. You probably don't need to recopy this down because it's right there on your paper. So I would say 4.74 plus the log of the base. Now, I'm going to kind of make a huge parenthesis here because I want to do something interesting here. Now, I want to go back where we found our concentrations up here, I think. Yeah, and so we had right here, I'll highlight it in pink, 25 millimoles over 75 milliliters. So I'm going to say 25 millimoles. Wait a second. Is that the acid or the base? Am I mixing
up? That one is the base. Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah, you got to put the base on the top. Millimoles over 75 milliliters. And then this other number was
6.25
millimoles divided by 75 milliliters. Now, let's just be mathematical, Mr. Sams. What do you see? Could you simplify this?
Oh, yeah. Let's cancel 75.
You see the 75s. That color doesn't work, does it?
No.
How about this color? The 75s cancel, don't they?
Yep.
So you do not have to actually calculate the molarity like we did just a bit
ago. If you have millimoles, it works in the buffers.
So all we need to do is take, on our calculator, 4.74 plus, so I would type it in, 4.74 plus log, parentheses, 25, divide, 6.25, parentheses, equals
5.34.
And that's, folks, the answer we got earlier. All you would have to do is use Mr. Henderson-Hasselbach. Now, a caution. When does Mr. Henderson-Hasselbach equation apply?
Only in buffers.
What's a buffer again?
You have to have a weak acid and its partner.
So, or a weak base. If you just had a weak base,
mm-hmm.
could I use it?
Nope.
Just a weak acid?
Nope.
No. I have to have the partners.
The partners.
Must have the acid and his partner, or the base and his partner. Okay?
Yep.
Now, on the base problem, just as a quick note, if I were to use the Henderson-Hasselbalch problem and I had a base, I would have to usually you have the KB. The equation says KA. So you'd have to find the KA using the KA times KB equation.
Yep.
So that's something to keep in mind as you did. All right, let's do a couple more examples here. Okay, calculate the pH of the following solution. Now we're going to use the shortcut method because it's better.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, better is shorter and good. Now, I think this is a buffer. We got to double check. What have we got? We've got hypochlorous acid. So we've got HOCl.
Hulk.
And what do we know about Hulk? HOCI. All right, what do we know about the HOCI? We've got 25 milliliters, and it's 0.150 molar.
Yeah.
Now, if you use the MV mole things, how many millimoles is that, Mr.
3.75 millimoles.
Okay, and then we've got KOCl. Now, in the KOCl, who do I care about?
OCl.
Just O... Mr. Sam.
It has a minus charge on it.
OCl negative!
Yeah.
OCl negative. What do I know about OCl negative? I've got 0.45 molar, and I've got it at 32 milliliters. So if I take M times V,
14.4
millimoles. Now, do we have a buffer?
We do. We have a weak acid and its conjugate partner.
And they're within a factor of 10.
Yes.
So now, to find the pH, we can use this cool Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. So we can say the pH is equal to the pKa plus the log... right?
You have to look up the KA of that.
So, you then have to look up the KA of HOCl. So, let's fix that out here. So, the KA, I'll come back to that screen. The KA of HOCl is equal to... The value of the KA is...
3.5 times 10 to the negative 8.
10 to the negative 8. So, Mr. Sams, we can take the negative log of that.
Negative log of
the KA.
3.5 times 10 to the negative 8.
Be 7 point something, right?
7.46.
7.46. So now I'm going to go back to this screen here. So that's going to be 7.46 plus the log of the base. Now I got to go back. The base, let's think this through. The base, this is an acid, and the his partner is a base. So the base is the 4.4 number. So that'll be 4.4 divided by, now I go back to the acid, I can't keep this in my long-term memory very well. Oh, it's 14.4 over 3.75. Most of you probably caught that because you had the papers in front of you. You simply just type that in and you get?
8.04.
So this could be done the long way, okay guys, like we did up here. If you remember this problem right here, we could go back and do this problem and do the X minus X plus X, da-da-da, get the KA, or we could just use Mr. Henderson-Hasselbalch equation and we become happy campers. We like happy campers. It's good.
Yep.
Okay? All right. Oh, actually, you know what we're going to do here? You know what I was going to do on this? We've already done this before. This is where we simplify. We're going to just skip this slide. It's unimportant. I've already shown
already
this concept to
yep.
you. And then we do want to do one more where we have a base
okay.
and use the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. All right, what have we got here? We have a pH when we have 25 milliliters of 0.5 molar methylammonium nitrate. Now, that sounds like a nasty chemical.
Mm.
Methylammonium nitrate. Now, guys, if you would take your book and open to the appendix or...